Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. It's been a long time since my last video tutorial. This is because I've been very busy launching my first augmented reality product, which is this product, flashcards, Arabic letters and numbers augmented reality. It is already launched since 15th of September 2016, and already the product is live on Amazon store now and available worldwide. Basically, what the product do is helping children to memorize Arabic letters, numbers, and animals' names using augmented reality technology. I'm sure you guys already heard about AR or augmented reality, but just in case you haven't heard of it, basically an AR is when you see a product through your device, you will see a virtual 3D object coming out of it and stay on top or around that product. If you play Pokemon Go before, well, that's one kind of augmented reality which is based on geolocation. This video is about sharing the knowledge that I've gained when developing the product. For months, me and my team, we've been working so hard to get this product published to the world. And along that road, we discovered a lot of new interesting things, and that's exactly what we want to share with you guys in this tutorial. This tutorial will be a multi-part videos covering different processes of making an augmented reality product from A to Z. Something you need to know though, these videos are not for beginners. It is just a quick how-to videos with the assumption that you already know and understand the basic stuff, okay? This is what we're going to create in this tutorial. A simple yet working augmented reality prototype using Blender, Unity, and Vuforia. I'm not sure how you officially call these plans, but basically it's a carnivore plan. So let's just call it carny for now on, okay? First, we're going to cover the workflow of how to develop an augmented reality product. Something you need to understand that making a working augmented reality app is actually pretty simple and easy. This is because there are dozens of AR tech providers which make the technology easy for us to use. They work so hard to make the underlying sophisticated part of the technology hidden, so everything is simple on the surface. The first hardest part of making an AR product is actually developing the content, which in our case the 3D object and its animation. That is why most parts of this tutorial are about 3D content development. The second most time-consuming part of making an AR product is making the image targets. You might be asking, what is image target? Well, they are the key images that will trigger the augmented reality content to appear and then continuously track by the AR engine through your camera device. For the case of my product, they are the images printed on the cards, the letters and the animals you see in here. To create the images, or should I say the illustrations of the flashcards, I use Adobe Illustrator to do all of the work. Adobe Illustrator is a very powerful software, but in this tutorial, we're not going to cover how I make the illustration using Adobe Illustrator. We'll be only focusing on the 3D and AR part of the product. But inshallah, I'll be making another video series about how I create the illustration using Adobe Illustrator in the near future. This image shows in general how we can develop an AR product. As we can see up here, we need to create the 3D model first, then give it colors in the texturing phase. After that, we add bones to the 3D object in the rigging process, so later in the animation phase, we can animate the object. Okay, so all of these phases are done in 3D software. For this, we'll be using Blender, because that is the software we use to develop our product. And as we mentioned earlier, these 3D development phases are what actually taking the longest time. Okay, after the 3D content are finished, by that I mean already animated, we can import them to the game engine. And we'll be using Unity game engine for this tutorial. In Unity, we can combine our 3D model, audio, and other media such as images for UI, and the most important part is the AR engine. For the augmented reality engine, we'll be using Vuforia. The nice thing about Vuforia is that it already provides Unity plugin that we can simply import it to our project. To make the AR works, we need to upload the images that we create using Adobe Illustrator to the Vuforia engine website. Their server will then process the image and convert them into database of image targets. We then need to download this database and include it in our Unity project. After everything is set up, we can publish the app into a working AR product. So that is the general workflow of how you build augmented reality product. Of course, there are alternatives to Blender, alternatives to Unity, alternatives to Vuforia, and alternatives to Adobe Illustrator. But since these are the tools that we use and we know, we'll be covering only these tools, okay? Well, except Adobe Illustrator. Okay guys, see you in the next part of the video where we will start using Blender to create the 3D model, inshallah. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Wassalamualaikum.